Dre, tell us how tough it's going to be out there, knowing you possibly could be the bad guy today.
Well, I don't know yet, you know, I haven't been out there, I don't know how it is. I just have to get used to the atmosphere, you know. I'm trying to focus on my tennis and then see what I can do out there.
How do you plan to focus on the match and not on the big occasion?
I just try to stay in the present, just to see it as another tennis match, you know, just focus on my game plan and just focus on my tennis, and that's what I will try to do.
Thanks, Benjamin. Good luck.
Thank you.
Benjamin Becker came through the qualifying, going to play the biggest match of his life against this great champion, Andre. Andre, a lot of fans yesterday were disappointed because of the rain. How much did it help you, though, to recover?
It did. It did a lot. There's no question that extra day does give me a look at the basket, but, you know, leaves me with tough proposition heading into this week, but good for today.
Against Becker, how important is it to get to a good start?
It's important for me not to cut corners early. I mean, I got as good or not good as I may be feeling, you know, I just can't cut any corners early. Have to work hard because if I work hard early, it might get easier for me. But if I don't, it's going to be a long day.
All right. Thanks, Andre. Best of luck. Continue to thrill him. Back up to you, Dick.
And thanks to Mary Jo as the two competitors make their way through the hallway that leads from the players' lounge out to the court. And this crowd here early ready to cheer Agassi from his very first step on Arthur Ashe court. It'll be Benjamin Becker, the 25-year-old first. Well,
how
Becker doesn't
drink,
even get the call.
He's just an opponent, a guy.
I have never seen Ashe Stadium this filled at 11 o'clock in the morning. I've never heard it sound like this.
They expect a total sellout, nearly 24,000. You can see some of the seats at the very top of this, the largest stadium in tennis, already occupied here to salute Andre Agassi. Agassi against the qualifier, who played at Baylor University and led the Bears to the NCAA championship a couple of years ago, and he was the singles champ. He's 25, not related to Boris Becker, although from Germany, grew up right near Luxembourg. In fact, that's just 10 minutes from his home where his mother
never even
works.
Met Boris yet.
Didn't meet Boris and has yet to talk to Andre until today. He'll hear a lot in the next couple of hours.
I love this one. It's quite romantic. Card member calls up, wants to take her husband to a really authentic Italian restaurant. I say, it's easy with our rewards program. Go online, pick almost any flight, you can pay with points and go.
Oh, tiramisu.
Italian food in Italy. Bellissimo.
This man finally popped the question.
You like it?
Oh, it's so beautiful.
But his Visa card was over the limit.
I'm so sorry. There seems to be a problem.
His fiance told him to call American Express.
Call 1-800-THE-CARD for the Preferred Rewards Gold Card. Okay, this one's so cool. A gold card member wanted a special gift for his wife's birthday.
Aww.
So I got him tickets through gold card events for the concert of the year before they went on sale.
Got him.
With the American Express Preferred Rewards Gold Card, you get all this and more. Call 1-800-THE-CARD and apply now and experience a world of service.
Cutting down on your coffee these days? Not to worry. Introducing Simply Smooth, a new stomach-friendly coffee from Folgers. We specially select and roast beans to reduce certain irritants that can affect a sensitive stomach. But we haven't reduced the mountain-grown aroma and taste you love. So go ahead, have a second cup. However, about that donut? Well, you're on your own. Simply Smooth from Folgers, the return of the second cup.
Alone. Lying. Thinking last night. How to find my soul a home. I came up with one thing, and I don't believe I'm wrong. That nobody, but nobody, can make it out here alone. You'll never be alone with the AIG companies by your side. AIG, the strength to be there.
Welcome back to the USTA Billie Jean King National Tennis Center. That's how this championship began on Monday night. The grand ceremony made it official that one of the great players and pioneers of the sport, Billie Jean King, the ultimate honor, this great facility named after her. And, of course, the court on which they play today, the Arthur Ashe Stadium. And Andre Agassi, A.A. Agassi. Arthur Ashe, AA, 36 years young, the oldest as he was last year in the men's draw. Las Vegas born and Las Vegas lives. 39th rank coming in, did not earn a seed, just missed that. And so if he should be victorious today, then Andy Roddick presumably would be his next opponent if Roddick wins today.
Well, we've certainly talked about and seeing these two matches quite often this first week. Two very, very tough matches. First, Andre Pavel, and then Marcos Baghdatis. That was just to get to the third round.
We mentioned Andy Roddick, who is scheduled to play next on Arthur Ashe, and he's over on a practice court tuning up. Jimmy Connors signed on as his coach right after Wimbledon, and the results have been outstanding in the hard court season, 14-1 for Roddick. Well, Benjamin Becker, as we said, he lives in what they call the three-country corner, just miles away from France and Luxembourg in Merzig, Germany, 25, so he gets a start late. A year ago, he wasn't even ranked, earned his first points down in Ecuador, and after this U.S. Open, he'll be in the top 100.
He's on a five-match win streak because he also had to go through qualifying. Apart from winning the two rounds he played to get to this match against Andre Agassi.
Charming and bright guy. We had a chance to talk with him. He was an academic star at Baylor, a 3.3 grade point average.
And took out a seed. Tough French veteran, Sebastian Grosjean.
Well, Grosjean suffered from having to play 2 days in a row. And when you're older, that's tougher to do. And that's obviously what you worry when you look at Andre today. You know, will he be able to do it tomorrow, presuming he beats Benjamin Becker? When I saw Becker for the first time, look at obviously a bit difference in their success as well as their age. He's at his highest ever ranking, Becker, right now. But when I went out to see if it wasn't Boris Becker at Wimbledon, you know, this guy can play a bit. I mean, he actually played a very close match with Fernando Verdasco, who Roddick will play later today. You know, lost 9-7 in the fifth in the second round. So this guy, you know, there's a lot more guys that can play good tennis on this on the tour now.
But, John, I thought it was interesting, and normally those pre-match interviews that we hear right before the players take the court, you don't get much out of them, but I thought it was telling that Andre Agassi said, you know, with the pain in his back and that all the tennis he's already played, the rest helped him for today, but not for the rest of the week. So I think Agassi's feeling very good about his chances beating Benjamin Becker today. I thought that said a lot.
He took another anti-inflammatory injection before this match, so he's thinking ahead.
The farewell journey at the U.S. Open for Andre Agassi. Opening serve coming up.
Three screens, wireless, broadband, and TV are now coming together. The new AT&T is bringing you all the ways you see your world, all on the most complete and secure network. The new AT&T, your world delivered.
Olympus may be a familiar face, but Olympus is also a world leader in research and clinical microscopes and diagnostics. Created the first camera that let doctors look inside the human body. And we continue to introduce life-altering imaging technologies for healthcare professionals. We're proud of these accomplishments, but we're most proud of how we enrich lives around the world every day.
Don't fret, little guy. It's normal to feel nervous. And in 2 hours and 32 minutes, when the stage is set and a million eyes are on you, we have no doubt that you will make us proud. Lexus, proud sponsor of the U.S. Open.
The real battle begins. Broncos, Rams, Bengals, Chiefs. Kickoff 2006, next Sunday on CBS.
Ready to go at Arthur Ashe Stadium, and with the backlog of matches because of the rains of yesterday and earlier in the week on Tuesday, there are 26 singles matches scheduled, and 12 of those matches feature a player that's won a Grand Slam title. It is an outstanding day of tennis. We're pleased you're with us. Our 7 hours of live coverage of the United States Open. Benjamin Becker serves it against Andre Agassi. Mile-an-hour miss, so he's got good pop on his serve.
Agassi's got that backhand. It's one of the greatest shots you'll ever see. His technique is awesome. I mean, this is the first point. He's already risked. It's not a bad way to get your first ball there.
Line drive winner.
He'd be a good baseball player, a double hitter, that's for sure.
So Alex slices the second serve ace at 99.
He's got a nice motion, Becker, and he doesn't put a lot of strain on his body. It's tough to read that serve. That's a good second serve. A lot of spin on that.
It up with a 133 mile an hour first serve. Agassi didn't like the call.
Yep.
Enrique Molina in the chair. Doesn't use one of his two challenges allowed in each set, plus one in a tiebreak.
Oh, man. I tell you, this guy can hit the serve. There's no doubt about that. He's shown that. 135. He's listed at 5'10", 174. Very impressive. 143, that serve. Think he's hyped up for this match?
And an easy hold for Benjamin Becker. Well, Agassi dueled the other Becker many a times, Boris Becker. In fact, they played 14 times, and Agassi won 10. Two of those here at the Open in the semis. In the 90 semifinals, he defeated Becker in four sets. And again in 95 on his way to the title, Agassi in four. And dismissed the Hall of Famer from Germany, Boris Becker. Benny Becker, not related. Of course, he said, I just say right away, first thing I say is no, because I know the question is, are you related? And as you mentioned, never had a chance to talk with Boris. Now that he's more successful on the pro circuit, he'll have an opportunity as Agassi starts with a double.
He says, Benny, he was telling us the other day, he's never even met a bunch of the German players. He's never met Nicholas Kiefer. He knows the Americans. He knows the college players like Jesse Witten, Jeff Morris.
If he can able to play well today and do something here and make at least competitive and possibly pull off the huge upset, he'll get a lot more guys thinking about going to college, which may be a good thing. 4 years at Baylor. I think it's interesting that he's got Tariq Benabiles as a coach, who was the original coach of Andy Roddick. And Nice to see Tariq back around the sport of tennis. Took Andy to the top 10. Worked with him as a young kid. He's done a good job with Benjamin Becker.
There's that kick serve that's been a good friend of Agassi through the years.
When you're tight, you don't move your feet very well. And you can see Becker having a little bit of trouble moving right now. Tension still in his body. He's in a position like this before, that's for sure.
And the ace for Agassi, one all. Benjamin Becker went to Baylor because a friend from Germany had preceded him by 1 year and talked him into coming over to the States. He said, that was my dream. In Germany, if you go to college, you don't get to play serious sports. So it gave me an opportunity for an education and to be an athlete, he said. But I was a little shocked when I went to the United States and I expected to see all these skyscrapers, and I landed in Waco. It was a little different than I had anticipated.
He doesn't lose points too often when he hits a 138-mile-an-hour first serve. And that's what just happened against Agassi.
Again handling the heat at 132.
This is coming at him at 132 miles an hour. Just a very quick little move with his shoulders and hips. And he drew the error from the server.
Andre's also a great wind player. The wind's moving around a bit out there, and he just is able to hit through the ball if he needs to, use spin. It could help going up in Vegas where those winds kick up often. Three break points here, it's one all.
Breaker saved. Agassi in position to claim the early lead.
You can tell that Agassi's still trying to feel out Becker, see what he's going to do with some of these shots. He's going to overhit early. Andre hasn't done much more than get the ball back and see what this guy's going to do.
He's figured out pretty quickly this guy can hit a big serve. He's just content to block it back and take it from there.
He might have to step it up a little bit because, well, this is new territory for Benjamin Becker. Like he's come to play as well.
Agassi passes the first test of stretching that sore back. Put the cortisone shot, 30 minutes, 7-inch needle after he played Monday night. That was Tuesday. And then took anti-inflammatories after the long match.
We've had three straight days of that, man, we hear. Like he moved too well there. Good off forehand from Becker. He's thinking ahead. He wants to keep the inflammation down for the match tomorrow. He No pain-killing ejection, apparently, but trying to minimize the damage if he would have played, if Andy Roddick wins later, him tomorrow afternoon. Gets you a little winded, Agassi, and then he forces you to go for a little bit more than you're comfortable doing. Becker had to work hard and did well to stay in this point. And then he got a shot that he should have done better with, but he got tight, caught it a little late, and he's down another break point.
Fourth break point. Effectively in the second round against Agassi. Tough to get off the mark quickly.
That's the time you want to do it. When you're in charge in the point, you've got some options. So Agassi's got to think he may hit through that. So that's a well-timed shot. This guy can serve.
Wife Steffi and children are here at Arthur Ashe Stadium. She does not sit with the rest of the Agassi clan. Saved by Benjamin Becker. Four break points. 2-1, opening set.
A breakthrough in serious hair care has been born. Now chronic damage is transformed. A technology so advanced, it could only be from Pantene. New Pro-V Restoratives. High-tech multi-pro vitamin systems mirror visibly healthy hair, actually changing the face of damage. Results beyond your expectations. Discover the new Frizz Control and Breakage Defense Collections. New Pro-V Restoratives from Pantene.
My allergies can get so bad, I feel like I'm in a fog.
Now, I'm Claritin Clear. Claritin relieves my sneezing and itchy eyes without making me drowsy.
And it's proven to make me alert and focused.
Lip Claritin Clear.
For those in the academic, medical, cultural, and research fields beginning to think about their financial future, we're TIAA-CREF. We have more than 85 years' expertise building retirement plans just for you. Let our experience and personalized objective advice help you meet your retirement goals, starting today. TIAA-CREF. Financial services for the greater good.
Come in and save at Circuit City's Red, White, and Blue Sale. You'll find hot deals in every department. And this Tuesday, pick up B-Day from Beyonce for just $9.99 at Circuit City.
Well, that last game and the hold by Becker saving four break points raised some eyebrows. Now it's Agassi, love 15.
Looking comfortable out there now, Becker. He's got some game. I mean, he's playing within himself now, and he's a solid player.
So far, he's hitting with more pace than Agassi. on the ground strokes, and we've seen how big he serves.
He's had a couple of quality wins, Benjamin Becker. Here he beat Grosjean at Wimbledon. He beat the tough Argentine Chela. He's 25 years old. I mean, in some ways, he is a veteran. And he's starting to have his best results now. Safin taking the first set from David Nalbandian, and he's been all over the map this year.
Ryan Sweeting, an American collegian, drops the first set. Lots of big names, not just on the show courts today. Oh, Lindsay Davenport has lost the opening set to Robotnik.
It's tough for Ryan Sweeting, though, Dick. Don't you think he's going to have to play six matches in 8 days to win this?
University
he's only in the second round. Him and Rokas and Nalbandian Safin. He's a break point for Benjamin Becker. That officially means he's still nervous out there. You know, the question is will he be overwhelmed by this occasion?
So far, so good for the Becker camp. He grew up in a soccer family, and that was his first sport, and still big fan, Cologne being his team in Germany. About age seven, he found an old racket in the garage and decided to bat a ball around. Oh, Agassi didn't move well at all there.
He's not moving as well, at least so far, as he did in his first two matches. Perhaps it's the earlier time. Getting out here at 11 o'clock. Still feeling the effects of those first two matches.
The fact that it is sunnier and warmer, and so in contrast to the gray and damp days we had when on the sit-downs you can cool off, at least that should help the back.
Well, you would think so. You hope so.
Earning another break point.
Well, Becker should see that he's, when he gets opportunities, he should just try to make Agassi play, especially not go for winners on the return. You know, he's been in the long end. This is the third deuce of this game already. And the crowd's, you know, sensing Agassi's not got it going yet. Struggling out there. Helped him so much, the service improvement, winning more points off that serve. A nice solid 118 there.
Both of his previous opponents, Pavel and Baghdad, is using the drop shot effectively. And Agassi battles through a tough service hold. It's 2-all. CBS Sportsline is the destination for complete U.S. Open coverage. You get the latest news and analysis when you click on tennis at cbssportsline.com. Set a men's record in the Open era with his 21st consecutive U.S. Open appearance. He first arrived here in 1986 at the age of 16. Lost that first match to Jeremy Bates. It's the only time in his career here at the Open that he's lost to a player ranked outside 100 since Bates. He's gone 24-0. He faces the 112th ranked Becker today.
Certainly doesn't want to end it against a guy out of the top 100. Becker's done a good veteran thing. He's you don't know him, but he's been around a bit playing the circuit. He's taking his time. He's not rushing here. That's a good sign for him.
He's doing everything he can, from the serve to the drop shots, to test the mobility of Agassi.
Not moving to the baseline. He's playing deeper than normal. Prevails in that long rally.
Tough rally, physical one there. Looked like Agassi clipped the line in that last forehand. Becker hoping it would go long. No call. This is the time for Andre to try to take advantage. He's a little winded. He's going to try to hit a big first serve, end this point quickly. He's got a real pop up the middle. I mean, he's hit it 136, got 138. So that slice out wide is effective. He's a good server, this guy. Doesn't look like his serve's gonna break down. However, his ground stroke's a different story. He's been wild out there early in this match.
Well, as you see him from the two wings, where would you play him? To his forehand or backhand?
Well, I think he's gonna make mistakes off both sides. He's having some trouble at Agassi's pace. He's got more on his forehand, that's clear. But he may make more errors off that side too, going for too much.
Serve 3-2. CBS Sports coverage of the U.S. Open continues after this message and a word from your local station.
The CBS Evening News with Katie Couric begins Tuesday.
Have you looked at your car's finish lately? Maybe it's time to get it painted. And now's the best time because Maaco is having a sale. At Maaco, you'll get a quality paint finish and a great deal. Best of all, Maaco will get the job done fast. Hurry and call today for a limited time only. Get half off our popular presidential paint package. If it's time to paint your car, visit your local Maaco Cosmolition specialist today.
With unmatched technology and innovation years ahead of its time, we've pushed the boundaries of high definition and tested the limits of reality. The new Pure Vision Plasma Display, only from Pioneer.
Everybody's watching Millionaire tomorrow at 9 on CBS Detroit.
Coverage of the U.S. Open on CBS Sports is sponsored by Circuit City, TIAA Cref, Crestor, and by Singular. On serve, opening set, Agassi at 2-3. Each man has had a chance to break.
Agassi putting something extra on that serve there, a second serve. Becker was looking to attack. Just clipped the top of the net.
We've spoken so much about how this is Andre Agassi's final tournament. It could very well be Lindsay Davenport's as well. And she's already down a set in a break.
Doesn't have the fluidity, the motion on his serve that he did the first couple of rounds either. He looks like he's struggling a bit, Andre, right now.
Does hold.
He's hanging in there at the moment.
Yeah.
We talk so much about, you know, we love listening to Andre Agassi talk about everything, but keep in mind that when he talks about his longevity, that's when I think he's very interesting. He talks about how it's all about handling pace through the years, and his mechanics have so much to do with that. He's always had a nice, clean, tight game, beautiful, simple strokes that have been able to withstand the increasing pace over the last 20 years of his career. Very much like Jimmy Connors and Ken Rosewall. Those kind of fellows have got the sort of swings that hold up against pace, whereas, you know, some great champions have not been able to do that. Like Martina Hingis, for instance, and John, much more of a touch game. Pace can overwhelm those kind of strokes. I like listening to Andre to a certain point when he gets zen and philosophical and all of that, but I really like listening to him talk about tennis. Right now, the pace of Becker is overwhelming Andre. He will have to move better so he can stay with this.
But he isn't. He's moving gingerly. You can see it again on that last point.
What I think Andre is going to try to do is hang close enough, you know, the latter points, parts of the set, and then hope the guy chokes or tightens up, you know, that he's around, because he has obviously so much more experience. At the moment, he doesn't have it in him to step it up. He's going to have to wait this out. Allow Becker to beat himself.
I remember in the 2002 final against Pete Sampras, it took him a couple of sets to warm up because he'd beaten Hewitt in a tough one the day before.
My cholesterol is out of whack. The doctor said my bad cholesterol's high, a real problem with my medical history.
And get this, my good cholesterol's low, so he put me on Crestor.
Crestor, along with diet, can lower the bad cholesterol. It can also raise the good. Crestor helps get my cholesterol where my doctor wants. That's more like it. Is Crestor right for you? Ask your doctor. Mine said Crestor isn't for everyone, like people with liver disease, or women who are nursing, pregnant, or may become pregnant, and simple blood tests will check for liver problems. He also said to tell him about other medicines I'm taking, or if I have muscle pain or weakness, that could be a sign of serious side effects. Down with the bad, up with the good. How's your cholesterol? Crestor helps get your cholesterol right.
If you can't afford your medication, AstraZeneca may be able to help.
Clear your inbox, clear your mind. The same email that's on your computer is now on your singular phone with one simple click. It's your email delivered. Get the new email ready Nokia phone for only $29.99. Singular, raising the bar.
Third round, opening set, no breaks of service, although each man has had an opportunity. Agassi had Becker facing four break points back at the one-all game, but Becker able to save his serve, and then Becker had his chance the next game. Agassi saved. Agassi having to go one-handed on the backhand twice in that exchange.
Becker's starting to realize that he doesn't have to hit as big a shot as he was earlier in the set. And that's if he's able to settle down here, he could really be dangerous. He takes that return early and gets ahead in the point. He's in good shape. See, that's what he's got to guard against, is you know, his easy misses, giving Agassi the point.
Coach of Becker, Jean-Luc Fontenot, and Tariq Anabilis to his left, who is his advisor, and Kristen Roof, the young lady, the girlfriend of Becker. Anabilis, as John pointed out, coach of Roddick, and then handed it off to Brad Gilbert.
That's not the way he would have described it, but yeah. Well, he's going for more too under on the serve. And he wants to win as many easy points as possible. That's his hardest second serve as you'll see from him, that's for sure.
And this is a smart idea, his third ace of the day. He's got to do something with the first ball he hits, whether serving or returning. There's another one. Because when he gets behind in these points, he's going to be in trouble. And, you know, we listen to Andre discuss what he wanted to have happen out there. And this shows, once again, that shot tracker shows it was good. He hit it for his second ace of that game. Andre wants three clean sets here. He wants to break a set at least. And this guy's doing a good job of holding on to his serve.
Held that ball nicely. Forced Agassi to lean one way, and he hit the forehand. A lot of topspin to keep it in the court.
That's huge with a lot of action.
Well, it's a nice serve because it looked initially like he was going to kick it out to Andre's backhand, the American twist serve, and then he took it and sliced it up the middle. Very nice serve from Becker.
And he uses the power 140 on that ace. Seventh ace for Becker. Straight points now for Benny Becker on his serve. And another hold at love. 5-4 on serve in the opening set.
Gil, you okay?
I'm going in.
Going in where?
I'm gonna save the company.
Save the company from what?
The servers. They're all over. Gotta get them before they get us.
Gil, we're switching to IBM servers.
That's a server?
It's a blade. Denser, so you can fit more into less space.
Did you say blade?
Gil, put the keyboard down.
Take back control with a scalable IBM Blade Center featuring dual-core Intel Xeon processor.
Is that your tie on your head?
That's yours.
Ordinary candles offer fragrance and ambiance, but many look too much alike. Now enjoy your favorite scents and a whole new sense of style with new Glade Trio scented oil candles. Create a centerpiece. Line them up. Or just use one to accent your decor. Trio's warming plate melts the candle into a pool of scented oil, quickly filling the whole room with fragrance. Enjoy your favorite scents and a whole new sense of style with new Glade Trio scented oil candles. SC Johnson, a family company.
You see a troubled steel business. At Franklin Templeton, we saw a chance to invest in a re-engineered steel company poised for a turnaround, building strong returns for our fund shareholders. Perspective like this has made Mutual Series a leader in value investing. Franklin Templeton Investments. Gain from our perspective. Ask your advisor for a prospectus with investment goals, risks, fees, expenses, and other information to read and consider carefully before investing.
Welcome back. Agassi serving at 4-5. Agassi's section. Verdasco Roddick play next on Arthur Ashe. The winners meet in the fourth round. Hewitt and Djokovic. That's a tough one.
Agassi requested this early start, and there are a lot more people here than they normally are at this hour, but the energy is not nearly the same as it was those first two night matches. He won, he'd have more time to recover because he knows he has to play tomorrow, but he's clearly at the moment not feeling too good out there.
And this big crowd that will reach to 24,000 today has seen what we've seen. Just not quite the bounce in his step nor the movement that he showed in the first two matches, but hanging on, a point away from 5-all, 2 points for 5-all.
Very, very useful for Becker. He can hit that consistently, as it was for Baghdatis the second round. That just opens the court up. It's there for him if he can hit it in consistently. Agassi's got to lean and expect that cross-court shot, which is a higher percentage play. He's won a lot of points off that serve.
Darren Cahill, his coach, at Agassi's camp. And this crowd applauding the hold at 5-all. You saw that startling statistic, but winners 18-6 in Becker's half.
This is where he hopes Becker tightens up late stages of the set.
Double faults, served well. Davenport earns that break back, so they're on serve in the second. Davenport down a set. And Patty Schneider, the seventh seed, moves through after dropping the opening set.
This guy's got seven aces, Becker, no doubles. He's hitting a big serve. He's got variety to it. He's not going to be easy to break if he can keep his nerve. Good play again from Becker.
And here on his serve, John McEnroe, Ben Becker has won 13 straight points. Well, he's dominating on his service games.
The good news is so is Agassi. So he's been able to hold relatively easily. Except early in the match, he had that 40 love first time Becker served. He snuck out of that, and that allowed him to relax a little bit.
Shot tracker showing that the bell was just out. Agassi played through that point. He won it anyway. So after 13 straight service points won by Becker, Agassi comes up with a couple and makes it interesting for the fans here as they're rooting for him to make this as quick an afternoon as possible. Agassi will serve for the tiebreak when we return. The Open will continue after this word from your local station.
Where can you see Tiger like you've never seen him before?
I'm nervous about this.
Where else? On 60 Minutes tonight.
Are we under attack?
I hope there's no one there.
Survivor tribes divided.
Black, white, Asian, Latino.
Start September 14th. Turn on the lights, crank up the heat, and feel the burn on CSI Miami weekends.
Stick around, I'm full of surprises.
CSI Miami weekend.
Premiere Saturday, September 16th. We are CBS Detroit.
Fort Grimm with Magic Window. Magic installs fiberglass windows. Our competitors install vinyl. Fiberglass is a great insulator. Vinyl is not. We insulate our homes with fiberglass, not vinyl. Magic's fiberglass windows are three times more energy efficient than our competitors' vinyl windows. The choice is obvious. Reduce your heating and cooling costs with Magic's energy-efficient fiberglass windows.
Get a house full of windows and pay nothing for 2 years. No interest, no payments. Call 888-77-MAGIC.
You know, when the producers came to me and said, John, we need to hire someone who's uniquely talented to host the new Family Feud, there was only one thing to say. Made to the order of John O'Hurley.
John O'Hurley hosts the all-new Family Feud.
Premieres September 11th. We are CBS Detroit. Everybody's watching Raymond.
Tonight at 11 on CBS Detroit.
After a full week of gray skies and a lot of rain, blue skies, a beautiful day for tennis, and the fans pouring into the USTA Billie Jean King National Tennis Center. And what a great schedule we have for you in our 7 hours of live coverage. And here's Andre Agassi serving at 5-6. Opening set, trying to get to a tiebreak against Benjamin Becker. 25-year-old German has played very well. Becker has, after having problems in his second service game, was down low 40, but saved 4 break points. Since then, he just has given Agassi very little in his service games. And Agassi has thrown in a good handful of aces himself. That's number 6. One less than Becker. Himself 2 points from grabbing the opening set.
He did to Agassi what Agassi normally does to his opponents, hurting, taking that return early. Those are the type of exchanges Andre wants to get in with Becker. He'll win most of those points. I believe that was called out.
I heard an out call.
And Andre's not going to question it. And this is set point now for Becker. People even realize that.
No, they were cheering that as if it were a winner.
That's it.
And the double fault. Becker owns the opening set. Boy, that really has put the silencer on this big crowd at Arthur Ashe Stadium. The German Becker takes the set 7-5.
It happened all the time. I'd be chatting away on my cell phone, and I get this weird feeling I was talking to nobody. Hello? Nothing. Because my network. So, I switched to Singular's all-over network. It's the network with the fewest drop calls. Testing from the leading independent research company proves it. Independent. That means no agenda, no bias.
So, switch to the network with the fewest dropped calls. Singular, raising the bar.
Life has little ways of reminding you.
I love you, baby.
Why you buy life insurance.
All right.
I love you.
This much?
Life has little ways of reminding you.
This much.
Why you buy life insurance.
So when it comes to healthcare, what do you believe?
I believe you should get the medicine you need no matter how much money you make.
I believe that families without drug coverage should get help from the drug companies.
I mean, I believe there's got to be a better way to get the help you need.
At Merck, we believe it's not enough to try to create innovative medicines. We need to help make sure our medicines get to the people who need them. Like the Merck Patient Assistance Program. It's been providing Merck medicines free to millions of Americans who can't afford them. You may be eligible for one of Merck's assistance programs. They are free to join and have no hidden charges. For more information on how Merck tries to make our medicine affordable for everybody, please call 1-800-50-MERCK or visit MerckHelps.com. Merck, where patients come first.
Welcome back. Let's go back to that 30-all point in the last game. Just wide, and Shot Tracker confirms that it narrowly missed the outside edge, and that gave Becker the break point and set point, and then the double fault by Agassi for the set 7-5. Becker.
I knew Agassi saw the ball well, but I mean, not to challenge that was a 30-all. I mean, that says something to me about his mental state. You know, he's not in a good place right now. Physically or mentally.
And now knows that to advance he's going to have to go four sets once again, and it's been an exhausting trip just to get to this third round, as two matches more than taxing emotionally and physically.
There it goes. You know, he made an extra effort to get down early in that return, the stance, the crouch, you know, which he hasn't done much in this match so far.
Now Lindsay Davenport rallies to take the second set. Agassi acted as though he thought that was an ace.
He needs a boost right now. He can get this early break, get the crowd more into this. Crowd's pretty quiet this first set. He's stunned by this unknown winning 7-5.
Well, maybe Benjamin Becker never met Boris, but he's certainly serving like him. That first serve of the first set for Becker, look how effective he was. Over 70% first serves won. And close to that in second serves won against the great returner of this modern age.
Pretty good set, 19 winners to only 7 for Agassi, 7 aces, no double faults. He's certainly not overcome by the occasion. Well, another winner.
You mentioned it, one all, Dick. He was down love 40. If Agassi had gotten that early break, it may have turned out to be a very big game. You don't expect it to be such early point of a three out of five set match, but that allowed Becker some breathing room to relax that little bit.
Now Agassi had four chances to break him, and all erased by Becker. Back to deuce.
Just one more thing to keep in mind, though.
Benjamin Becker has only played three out of five set matches before in his whole life. So that might be something else to think about as this match progresses.
He said when he got into this championship, all of a sudden he's ahead by two sets. I got to play another one? I'm used to that. There's the break point for Andre Agassi, his first since the third game of the match.
It's almost as if Becker's realized I have a chance to win this, and he's played a tight game here. And this would be good for a lot of reasons if Agassi get this break right now. Not least of which to get the crowd more energized.
Yeah, they're ready to use their voices. They came to cheer Agassi. Andre gets a second ball on break point.
He's moving back. He's literally 12 feet behind the baseline to hit the serve.
And it's long. Agassi does break to start the opening set, or the second set, after losing the opener. And the crowd now ready to roar.
I guess he's used that tactic in the past where he'll throw his opponent off by changing the position of where he returns the serve. But, that, you know, obviously he's not moving as well. So that gives him more time to line up and gives more time for Becker to think about the next shot. So that turned out to be a good play for him, knowing Becker's not going to come in on that second serve.
Yeah, it's not the Agassi you normally see and cheer. He likes to get up, crowd that baseline, get inside the baseline, take the ball early. But in the match thus far, because of the back, we're guessing, I mean, he's just not as mobile. He's had to give some ground and really did in that last couple of points.
Lindsay Davenport took the last five games of that middle set and is already up a break. Now seven games in a row in the third against Katarina Zrobotnik.
Some question as to whether or not Lindsay would even be able to play in this U.S. Open, having to retire just a week ago.
Patty Schneider recovering from a tough first set. Dinara Safina easy. Her brother Murat is also playing. Is up a set against David Nalbandian.
Just wide.
He's got a little bit more hot now. He's starting to, it's like the wake-up call has come.
He might have needed that first set just to loosen up a little bit. And then that break, that last game, he only hit one winner, Agassi, but it was four errors from Becker that caused that break.
Yeah, it's key here for Agassi with the early lead to secure that opening break.
Some zip on that serve, though. I mean, it's really, he's just spinning it in. Seems.
92 miles an hour on the second serve, 98 on that first one.
That's it. And early in the match, he was hitting his serve, but at the moment, he's having trouble just using his legs, which he needs to generate some pop. And that's Becker a chance to break.
Forehand error from Becker's end. Saving the break point, Agassi.
That's a tricky situation for Andre. You know, he never played like Pete Sampras, you know, where he could just dominate and overpower opponents. He was more Connors-like, grinding people. I'm not
sure he's fit enough to grind against Benjamin Becker, who's already had to do that through the first few rounds. I think he needs to go for quicker points.
Seventh ace gives him a point for two love.
He's right there. He barely moved for that. He just took a long step. He balanced this off. That's not normal for Andre. Just reach for this ball.
Hurts to watch.
Still, you know, trying to figure out a way to win this thing, despite how bad he feels. Late call. That serve called out.
Premature as Becker stays in the point with that defensive lob.
That's actually the best he moved in this match, but this was a great get by Becker. Good defensive lob, and by this time Andre was desperate and just went for the winner. He wasn't in position to hit it.
Another break point for Becker.
Let
call from umpire Molino. There's a beeper device that on the top of the net cord that registers in the umpire's chair, so he makes the call. There's the wiring system. Agassi fighting his way through another long rally.
I kept waiting for Becker to hit that drop shot, but it was Agassi that did it first. And Becker was there in plenty of time, and that's, you know, that's just feeling the pressure, because that's a shot you would think he would normally make. This is a different circumstance right now here at Arthur Ashe Stadium.
Two break points saved. Here's a third for Becker.
He's had his most success returning when he's pulled an Agassi, you know, kept that backswing short, taking it early, hurt Andre there again.
Fourth deuce, this is the longest game of the match. A 36-year-old Agassi battling through. Down the set, saving three break points in this game. Another chance for Becker to draw even in the second set.
That's a good play from Becker again. He sliced that back and kept it low, which forces Agassi to get down lower. He just couldn't do it. That's normally a shot he'd eat up there. Certainly concern in the Agassi camp.
Able to do some good business in that ad court by kicking wide. Worried expression there from wife Steffi and Darren Cahill, coach of Agassi. High marks to Becker in his debut here at Arthur Ashe. pulled.
He's trying to mix up the pace and spins of his serve, too. Keep Becker off balance. That's why he's forcing the issue there, throws the double, and this is the fifth time that Becker has a chance to break this game.
After losing his service and the opener. Oh, that was Agassi, classic Agassi, yeah. Half-fouling from the baseline.
I mean, this is a great return. Look where he hits the ball from. That's not where you're taught to hit balls, you know, standing in between the baseline and the service line, yet he comes up with some magic there. He needed that.
And the ace to follow. Not been easy here in New York for Agassi. Another match that, if he's to win, it's going to take him a lot of time, already an hour consumed, and we're just in the second game of the second set. Pleased that you're with us for our 7 hours of live coverage. 12 Grand Slam title holders are involved in singles play today. There's another double, his fourth. And one of those, Lindsay Davenport, a U.S. Open champion, has a break lead in the final set against Srebotnik. Number six break point for Becker.
Certainly doesn't want to play a lot of games like this. You make this type of effort, you want to hold.
This is the 22nd point of this game.
That's a great effort from Andre.
And they stand here at Arthur Ashe to salute the gameness of the veteran Agassi. Fights through 6 break points in that game.
Kind of tough to watch. And when he finally held on, it looked like he was going to start doing one of those little hops that he's been doing. He didn't even bother. I don't think he's even up for that, it seems.
And finally a double fold, a first from Becker's end.
He's got to put out of his mind that there's two games he should have won. Instead, he's down 2-love. Seems a bit rattled at the moment. First double there.
Comes right back with a big serve.
Yeah, he can fall back in that serve, which is, it doesn't look like it's a motion that's going to break down often.
And then he slices one wide at 111 miles an hour.
This has got such a nice natural rhythm on the serve. It doesn't look like he's trying to go big. He's got heat. He's got a changeup. And he's forcing Agassi to stretch a lot, torque, move back, try to cut it off by moving in. Now Agassi, this is not a good return game day for Andre, and that's usually what he does best. And that has so much to do with balance and court positioning. One of the reasons Agassi has been such a tremendous returner of serve. Now he's given up a lot of the court, trying to hit it from way back.
Okay.
trusting that if he can get a nice enough piece of the return, then he can move into the court. Okay, this is for a second serve. Look where he's standing.
Becker holds. Agassi leads in the second set. Down a set.
How old am I? Here's a clue. In high school, I was all about my hair. Think I had straight 70s hair or big 80s hair. I finished college with a 4.0. Think I did my papers on a typewriter or a computer. I'll never tell.
Lots of things can give away your age, even the color of your teeth. So whiten yours with Crest White Strips Renewal. The age-defying strips go beyond the surface to remove up to 20 years of your toughest stains, letting you keep your age all to yourself.
Does knee pain limit your motion? Get relief with Icy Hot Pro Therapy, powered by Cold Pack.
Now I can scramble.
I can feel it work.
It goes the distance. Pro Therapy from Icy Hot. It's about freedom of motion.
We've come to the birthplace of gridlock with two cars and one goal. Get off the island first. The new 303 horsepower Lexus GS 350. You can't lose.
This Sunday and Monday only at Circuit City. Get no interest for 18 months store-wide on all purchases $4.99 and up. Plus, all CDs are just $9.99 each. This Sunday and Monday only at Circuit City's Red, White, and Blue Sale.
Midday and a big, big audience here at Arthur Ashe Stadium. Capacity almost 24,000. Here to see Andre Agassi, his farewell open, his finale is one of the tennis greats. He's down a set, 7-5, but leads 2-1 here in the second against Benjamin Becker, Baylor All-America, NCAA champion a couple years ago.
Both players have served well in spots. Not particularly high percentage, but Agassi barely moved on that last return. Not move his feet at all. It's a good pop. Becker's stepping in and taking that second serve early. That's a good play.
It's been the forehand that has let Becker down in the match, even though he leads by a set.
Becker's going for a lot more, and he's made plenty of mistakes. There's a lot of returns he's missed, and often let Andre off the hook, it appears. But Andre's kept him off balance with different paces and speeds.
Still get the sense that Becker is going to have to lose this match for Andre to advance.
I think Andre realizes that, too. He's definitely pulled back. Just hope for the best. You wouldn't think a total unknown would be dictating play against a guy who is a great ground stroker as Andre and a returner server. But that's what he's been forced to accept here.
The excruciating back pain that goes with his injury, however, will reduce the legend to normal. And Agassi cannot overemphasize the courageous nature of his appearances here at the Open. I mean, he's playing hurt.
Those first two matches have taken their toll, because this is the worst he's looked out of the three, no doubt about it.
A writer from the executive producers of ER and The West Wing comes a new drama starring Ray Liotta, Smith. It premieres Tuesday, September 19th here on CBS. Well, Agassi leads in the second set 3-1. Becker 7-5, the winner of the opening set. is he retreating deep once again.
He even caught that late, 10 feet behind the baseline. I think the big thing there, if you were to look at that, is how few points Agassi's won off the second serve. That's unusual.
And another ace at 131 for Becker. Oh, he generates some power off such a small frame. 10 aces.
Well, it's like Mary said, though. It doesn't look like he's forcing it. He's serving within himself, and yet he's got all this power and variety. Great serve, Becker pulled it off.
Fastest speed, 120 for Agassi, and Becker up over 140 in this match. And the slice serve, 100 miles an hour, Nace. Our coverage continues after this word from your local station.
Academy Award nominee James Woods, Shark, premieres September 21st after CSI.
Mort Krim with Magic Window. Magic installs fiberglass windows. Our competitors install vinyl. Magic's fiberglass windows come with a lifetime guarantee. Our competitors' vinyl windows don't. Magic can offer a lifetime guarantee because fiberglass is 8 times stronger than vinyl, and fiberglass doesn't warp like vinyl. The choice is obvious. Get a lifetime guarantee with Magic Fiberglass Windows.
Get a house full of windows and pay nothing for 2 years. No interest, no payments. Call 888-77-MAGIC.
Come with us on a journey to a world both real and imagined. A land of endless vistas and scarlet sunsets. Come with us to Boblo, the ultimate gated community. The island retreat so many have dreamed of owning. A private island paradise where the past and the present will come together in a grand new vision. The new Boblo Island, an unparalleled investment opportunity, will take luxury living to new heights.
Let's get inside.
I'm Pat O'Brien. Join me for The Insider.
Get inside.
Coverage of the U.S. Open on CBS Sports is sponsored by Mass Mutual, Lexus, Avodart, and by Circuit City. With Mary Carrillo and John McEnroe, Dick Enberg, and all our CBS team here at the U.S. Open. Our live action continues 7 hours on this Sunday, and Andre Agassi, down a set, serves at 3-2 in the second.
Law 15.
Oh. He doesn't need luck, too, Becker. Clips the tape, falls over on Agassi's side. If he gets breaks like that, he might find himself in the fourth round.
Agassi, for those of you just joining us, has battled a tough week. This is his farewell performance as one of the tennis greats. Took a 30-minute cortisone shot on Tuesday after a long match against Pavel. Then his anti-inflammatories after another long test on Thursday night. Marco Baghdatis playing with a painful bad back against the young Becker.
Gotta watch it here now, Andre Agassi. He knows he doesn't have to win another point off Becker's serve for the rest of the set if he can just hold his serve a few more times. The only time until this moment when Becker has been able to break Andre, Agassi double faulted on that Becker break point. But now it's different.
Yeah.
Saved 6 breakers in the first service game of this set, and now faces love 40. More and more looking like a fighter pinned against the ropes and wounded.
That's in too.
And at love, Becker breaks even the second set at 3-all. Meanwhile, Lindsay Davenport. Some are speculating that this could be her last U.S. Open, and the 10th seed is even with the 22nd seed Srebotnik at 4-all. Final set.
Let for service.
Winner of this match will play either Verdasco or Roddick. They meet next on Arthur Ashe today. Tough lefty, Verdasco, one of the many fine Spaniards here in this championship. Can't help but think back, Mary and John, to the French Open a year ago when Andre with a bad back played Jarkko Niemann and limped his way out of Paris, but fought through the four sets. Even though he had the early lead, he wasn't going to walk off, retire, allowed Niemann to win.
Yeah, he was up 2-1, lost a fourth, and then, you know, he's really struggling. And it was, he even, you know, continued on 6-0 in the fifth, and he wanted to give his credit to his opponent. That says a lot about him. He's in obvious pain.
13-15.
You start to even wonder, you think in the same thing now, you know. Should he keep playing? I mean, you don't sense he's going to stop, but it is tough to see right now. He's still trying to find a way to win. That's just
Becker is a solid player and much better, I think, than most anticipated they would see today. Darren Cahill.
Maybe get that white towel out, you know, like they do in boxing. Sometimes a player needs to help from himself. You don't want certainly any long-term damage for Andre here.
Just no pop in his ground strokes now. As Becker with a 4-3 lead in the second owns the opening set.
I think it happens to a lot of guys over 50. See, I was always going during the movies and hating to stand up, going during a presentation and hating to stand out. And once I got there, I had trouble going, and I was going 3 times a night. I said to my doctor, I have a going problem. He said, you have a growing problem. It's not your bladder, your prostate is growing. See, I had an enlarging prostate. My doctor prescribed Avodart.
Most medicines only treat symptoms. Avodart, with time, actually shrinks the prostate and improves urinary symptoms.
So, I can go more easily when I need to go. And go less up.
Only your doctor can tell if your symptoms are from an enlarged prostate and not a more serious condition such as prostate cancer. So have regular prostate exams. Avodart is for men only. Women should not take or handle Avodart due to the risk of a specific birth defect. Tell your doctor if you have liver disease. Rarely sexual side effects, tenderness, or swelling of the breast can occur. Call your doctor today. Avodart for your growing problem.
Morning.
Morning.
So excited for your match today?
Can you tell?
Just a little.
A passion for tennis, a passion for life. Mass Mutual, the life insurance company proud to support both.
And welcome back, and this is Agassi walking to the chair after that last game, disheartened and obviously not 100%.
You know, the crowd is obviously trying to rally Andre, but it's almost as if they know how much pain he's in. You know, they don't even want to push him too much. They're worried. You know, it's like everyone collectively is worried about him.
But, you know, what's interesting is Didn't you feel the same way in the Pavel match and the Baghdadis match? It almost seemed like, oh, gosh, I just hope he can hold together.
He looked a lot better. You know, he moved a lot better in those matches. This is really struggling here.
That's his only chance, Agassi. Is it Becker? Becker goes away. Lindsay Davenport needs to serve to stay alive in her third round match against Katerina Srebotnik.
He's had a complicated relationship, as he's talked about with his father, Andre. But I saw a quote from his father saying he should not play, you know, after that match against Baghdadis. So much was taken out of him. He's, you know, struggling there. You can see why there's an argument for that.
Yeah, he said he wished he had just announced there that that's it. That's my final match.
Well, he thought this serve.
I guess he thought this serve was long, so he wasn't really playing this rally.
He can't challenge Becker's call. That's way in.
From 40-15 to deuce.
Now his great friend and trainer Gil Reyes says that all Andre wants is to be able to lean into the tape at the end. Doesn't look like he'll be able to do that.
Harry, I don't see Gil there.
I think he's with Steffi.
Okay. Dug deep to hit that serve.
Yeah, is there any doubt about the man's heart? There's Gil Reyes, who since 1990 has been the trainer and confidant, close friend of Andre.
He can barely move now. And that's what Andre always said. All he ever wants when he enters tournaments in these last couple of years has been to give himself the best chance to have a look at winning.
He doesn't want to limp out. That, in his own words, said, "I just don't want to limp out of New York."
He might.
Yeah, his dad, Mike, he said after the Baghdadis victory, "I hope that was his last match. If it's up to me, I wouldn't let him go out and play his next round. His retirement is overdue, not because of his age, but because of his illness. His back just plain hurts." Ready, holds for four all.
Well, this is just a couple examples of Andre's obvious difficulties. I mean, he's just standing there, just reaching for the ball, unable to bend there, backtracking there, with no real effort. I mean, balance isn't there. He just can't push off. And somehow he could figure out a way to win this. You know, he's got to come back and play a tougher match tomorrow.
Against either Andy Roddick or Fernando Verdasco, we'll meet next here on Arthur Ashe Today. We'll have that match for you, as well as Serena Williams later. She's third up. Caught the outside of the line. And Davenport does hold her serve, 5-all in the final set. Oh, there's Agassi of old. Yeah, they'll cheer.
That was 135. Becker struck that serve. It's classic Andre Agassi.
Should have said Agassi of young.
That ball looked like it was in. He's going to challenge that. He's going to get some people against him, that's for sure. But I think you'd see the ball caught did.
Just did bite the outside of the line.
Benjamin Becker was asked in a press conference a couple of days ago, what's the most hostile crowd you've ever faced? Because obviously he's wearing a black hat today, and he laughed and said, probably playing college tennis, Baylor against Texas Tech. About 200 people, he said, were hoping he'd lose.
Would you mind turning your
back?
Thank you. Thanks,
Franklin. Agassi, there's a reflection off a badge behind Becker that was bothering Agassi. Again, unable to get to that backhand. Second booth in from the left. That's where the replay official seats, and his seat there offers his advice as well. But the process is very quick. I think the fans have really enjoyed it, the challenge system. Dale Bradshaw is the official today. There on the left. And the fans have really been involved in all the challenges. They have their opinion. They cheer, boo.
Still in this game, that clipped the line. And he needs to get through the second set, get back in this match. He obviously does not want to get down two sets to love. Now the crowd's involved.
That one just did hit the baseline. A break point. Now this huge crowd, be a sellout today, came in part just to pay tribute to Andre Agassi, and he's giving them all he has, even though it's not the 100% that we've enjoyed through his tremendous career, 21 consecutive appearances here at the Open. Does he have a miracle in him today?
Becker actually thought his backhand was going to float long, and so did Andre. Andre did not seem ready to hit this forehand. Maybe the wind caught it, but that was a bad miss hit.
That was a chance for a 5-4 lead, and serve for the set. Back to deuce.
Telltale sign of nerves is he's missing a lot of first serves, and Becker has this game, but he still looks like he'll be able to pull it out perhaps. Got an ad.
They play a final set tiebreak here at the Open, and that's what Davenport is serving to accomplish now over at Louis Armstrong. That's a grandstand, that competition.
But not yet.
Finds a way, doesn't he?
He's a better volleyer than he's ever been, in my opinion. I mean, this is a good shot right here. The ball's low from Becker. Agassi really handled that well. He's got that racket prepared nicely to go to either side. Gets the job done. Becker can't find a first serve.
12 aces for him, just one double fault. Another big second serve. His serve has been so effective that he just won command of the point early.
It's got some good pace and some spin. It's just put Andre immediately in a defensive position. It's not where he wants to be.
And the ace is 13th of the match. 5-4, second set.
Stanley Smith is a real Geico customer, not a paid celebrity. So to help tell his story, we hired a celebrity.
I love my car like my own wife.
He loved his car. Qué romántico.
When I wrecked it, I was devastated.
When he wrecked it? Estaba loco. No sabía qué hacer. Desesperado. I gotta get going. Where I'm going. What am I gonna do? Help.
Geico repaired it within a few days, like new.
In a few days, reparado su carro y was repaired, mejor que nunca. Ver it new. Estoy muy impresionada.
Geico. Real service, real savings.
I'm so happy porque tu coche sabe cuando me van a dar un coche.
Avoid unwanted leftovers. The scrubbing power of Cascade meets the grease-fighting power of Dawn. Cascade 2-in-1 action packs, so even sticky foods won't stick. Cascade 2-in-1 action packs, dishwashing that's truly automatic.
More bars in more places. That's what people have come to expect from Singular. And now they can expect even more. Testing from the leading independent research company proves that Singular's all-over network has the fewest dropped calls of any wireless network. The fewest dropped calls. Proof that we mean what we say. Raising the bar.
Andre Agassi in his final U.S. Open. Hopes it's not today, but he's down a set and serves 4-5 to stay in the second set against 25-year-old German Benjamin Becker. American collegiate star at Baylor. And John, you pointed out how you admire the college players that come into the pro ranks and get some of that education, and Becker's one of several that are involved in this championship. James Blake at Harvard, Paul Goldstein at Stanford, Ryan Sweeting at Florida. Off the baseline.
Unfortunately for NCAA champions, they haven't done particularly well in the pros, so that's discouraged prospects from hanging in there.
And Lindsay Davenport into a tiebreak to decide who moves on to the fourth round. No, that's wide, and Agassi really buckled in pain as he tried to reach for that drop shot.
He's limping noticeably, you know, after missing that ball. I see him come up. He's got time. He's lined it up. But right there, he didn't use his legs at all. And that's what happens when you hurt your back. You're afraid to really get low. So you end up hunching over to your back, which makes it even worse.
That second serve, and Becker ready to rip that backhand return.
That's what Agassi normally does to his opponents.
Perhaps the biggest moment of young Becker's tennis life, that's for certain, playing the idol and legend. No room for sentiment on his end. This is a day for him to put in his history bank. He's 2 points from a two-set lead.
I guess he just floated in, just looking to end the point, and didn't hit a good volley. Becker had a real good chance to get a set point there. He tightened up. And again, this way Andre's going to win this is just hope Becker's level of play drops, and the occasion's too much.
And the ace for Agassi to 5-all.
He certainly needs a set, Andre. Get down 2 sets to love. It'd be, I think, doomsday for him, the way he's feeling.
Andre's 9th ace. In the east, 10 o'clock for you folks out watching on the west coast. part of our 7 hours of coverage, all the way to 6 o'clock Eastern time today. Benjamin Becker from Germany against Andre Agassi. Third round action, and Becker with a set lead, serving at 5-all. Second set. Playing against an Agassi that is hardly 100%. Working through a painful back that has bothered him throughout the championship, but he's managed to make it to the third round. Meanwhile, Srebotnik and Davenport in a tie break to decide that match, and Davenport up a mini break, 3-1. Patty Schnieder, one of the top 10 players, has moved through to the fourth round with a win today. Rosano is the woman who dismissed Martina Hingis.
13-15. That is about as good a second serve as you'll see, unless you're Pete Sampras or Goran Ivanišević. This guy's only 5'10", complete unknown. He's serving like another Becker that we used to watch.
Ace for Becker runs his count to 15. Agassi will serve to get into a tie break when we return to Arthur Ashe, but let's go to that tie break over on Grandstand.
All right, Dick, thanks very much. Iron Eagle, Pam Shriver. Lindsay Davenport staved off two match points at 5-6 in the third set to force the third set tie break, and now leads it 4-2. Over Katarina Srebotnik.
Yeah, Davenport so brave on the two match points, came to net and hit a backhand volley winner at 15-40 down, and then Srebotnik missed a return. Didn't make Davenport play for the second match point. Srebotnik is down the near part of the court, will be returning this serve of the 6'2" Davenport, who won here in 98, and perhaps playing in her last U.S. Open.
Three now, Davenport. Third set tiebreak. Roller coaster ride for her. Came out flat in the first set. Second set, rallied against Srebotnik. And then seemingly in control in the third set when Srebotnik showed some signs of life. Andre Agassi over at Ashe. 5-6, second set, trailing one set to love to Benjamin Becker.
Srebotnik now with two serves.
Davenport
lost last year at the U.S. Open to Dementieva, 7-6 in the third and final set tiebreak.
That was a quarterfinal match against Dementieva.
And just 10 days ago, these two played in New Haven, Davenport winning 6-3, 6-3.
Agassi up 30-15 at 5-6 in the second set on Ashe. And Lindsay Davenport with a chance to advance on to the fourth round. Match point.
Just 5 minutes ago, she was down two match points.
Davenport still has a couple of match points to work with. Agassi has held against Becker. They are entering a second set tiebreak with Becker leading one set to love.
Davenport taking her time here. She has two more match points. This is the one on her serve that she wants. She served 10 aces in the match already.
And Davenport had a chance to put Srebotnik away.
Perfect serve, had the backhand, went for her favorite down the line, and Davenport cannot believe it.
It looked tailor-made. Agassi up 1-0, second set tiebreak.
Up a mini break. Agassi now with two serves. Srebotnik fighting off, trying to fight off her third straight match point.
Open. Davenport advances as we head back to Ash and Dick Enver.
All right, thanks, Ian and Pam. And here it's 1 point all in the tiebreak. We just had a challenge, and it was won by Becker. Point had been given to Agassi, but on the challenge, Becker won. And to level it at 1 point all, as you saw, Agassi wins that point 2-1 on serve here in the tiebreak. This is from Agassi's end. This is the match. This is his chance to maintain hopes of moving on in the tournament.
Becker tossed a double in the first point he serves, and he's feeling the pressure right now, big time.
Only his second double fault in the match. And there's another. Legends do live forever, and Agassi has earned that privilege. Good wide serve. 3 points to Agassi. Now serves. Yeah, the thing about bad backs, they're not like cramps where sometimes you can work it out and, you know, with activity, somehow it goes away. The bad back does not. Agassi but fights through it, has the lead in this tiebreak. 4 points to two. They'll change hands.
Well, that was almost a hop and a skip for him. He's really walked slowly, and now the crowd's fired up because they see that Agassi could pull this second set out and make somehow come back.
Becker, although his pro career very brief, because of that big serve of his, you saw that he's 5-0 in tie breaks. He throws in a double fault. So there goes the mini edge, 4 points to three.
Looks like he caved in on himself at the end of this. You know, he's lost an awful lot of pace on his serve in this match. That one just 96 miles an hour. And then you can see it seems to be a painful response to even having the serve. And with what Andre Agassi has got wrong with his back, it's not like he could be treated on a changeover.
Becker shouldn't have stopped playing.
explain that.
How did that get over?
Well, there was no call. Becker stopped playing. I mean, that was not a good decision from him. Ball looked to me like it clipped the back of the line. He just stood there watching. I guess he...
Let's see what shot Cracker shows that did catch the line. Agassi with the lead, 5-3.
Could be the difference in the set.
And three set points.
And Agassi gave that one a little more heat. Leaned in on that backhand, and that surprised Becker. Calls the error.
Well, he stepped it up. He's got that adrenaline pumping. This is huge for Andre.
One set point saved. Two more for Agassi. This is the big one on his serve. Under pressure and pain, and Agassi has leveled the match at one set all.
Unstoppable. Sasha Cohen is. So is her Citizen Echo Drive. Fueled by light, it never needs a battery. It's unstoppable. Just like the people who wear it. Citizen Echo Drive watches. Unstoppable.
You can take your clothes, put them in the sun. You're going down the road, baby, and you can't come back. Someday, baby, you ain't gonna worry for me anymore.
Olympus may be a familiar face, but Olympus is also a world leader in research and clinical microscopes and diagnostics. Created the first camera that let doctors look inside the human body. And we continue to introduce life-altering imaging technologies for healthcare professionals. We're proud of these accomplishments, but we're most proud of how we enrich lives around the world every day.
Unstoppable. Michael Waltrip is. So is his Citizen Echo Drive. Fueled by light, it never needs a battery. It's unstoppable. Just like the people who wear it. Citizen Echo Drive watches. Unstoppable.
Yeah, the last 2 minutes, the crowd on its feet celebrating. It's not a victory that will advance him to the fourth round for Agassi, but he has won a set, and fans came and realized it's going to be a tough day for this veteran. And how rich that moment was that he was able to win the tiebreak. See what's left.
How about that sign, you know, down from Argentina, coming up 5,300 miles just to see him play. That says something about Andre worldwide, not just here. They love him.
Isn't that the truth? All around the world, he's just so popular, always has been. Even that brash image kid, they loved him then, and now they embrace him all the more. starts this third set with a double full.
He's limping now.
Six double.
We didn't really see that. We saw it after both of his early round matches, going in and out of the press conferences, walking to his car. Now he's walking with a limp on the court.
He was moving better in that tiebreak, and he did step it up. He's been out there 150 now. He's still just starting the thirds. He's going to be out there a while more. At the very least, it's going to be a three-hour match.
You can see him just wince after every service attempt.
Becker was furious at himself in the tiebreak, you know, that he had let this one slip away. Agassi's back to sort of just reaching for the ball. And he had it going in the tiebreaker, but he seems to have lost that edge here. But
just long.
And he's going to challenge that Becker. On the left, this would give him two break points. And that'd be a nice boost for him if you're able to get on top here, quiet the crowd a bit.
Quickly, the official review, and
that looks like it's in.
The red nicked the line.
He's three for three now, Becker.
15-14.
By the fuzz of the ball, that gives him the two break points. Keen eye, this Becker. He's challenged and won all three.
13-14.
Easier for Agassi. He'd hit the ground shook than to serve. At the moment, he's just spinning it in.
89 miles an hour for serve. Last one. And there's the break, and Becker takes the early lead here in the third. And one has to wonder how long Agassi can maintain this competition. Under the pain that he is.
He didn't even sit down.
No.
He didn't even, well, he's not supposed to, but he's walking like an old man.
Just tender steps.
It looked like he would be able to will his way after winning that second set, and then all of a sudden he realized he still felt bad, and it's just this letdown. It's just noticeable now. Becker picked up on it. He's got the quick break.
And after the late night marathon with Marcos Baghdatis Thursday night into Friday morning, Gil Reyes said that Agassi was in so much pain that he had to lie down on his way to the car in the parking lot.
Yes, but it almost seems like he's better off returning. Becker's hit a big serve, but it's less strain on the back. He's got a chance to break back here.
Love 30 opening. Becker to come forward. Hasn't done that much.
Well, he's 11 out of 14. That's pretty good. See that ball smack the line. He's coming in good approach shots, and he sees Agassi's off balance. That makes life a little bit easier when you have to hit a volley.
Side in.
Both of you.
This is just a good, solid point because Agassi is trying desperately to break back here, not give Becker any momentum again. That falls on the line as well.
He's been painting a lot of lines in this match, approaching 2 hours in length. So all the things Agassi did not want to have happen, one, to fall behind early, and two, to have a long day's work, has gone against the game plan. And he earns the break point with that backhand.
He's got to hurt Becker off that return, especially on the second serve, so he can dictate play. He's not used that shot for a while, but he picked a good time to do it there. See, Andre just did not do enough with this return. Didn't have much on it and gave Becker some time to think that one over. Last serve that Becker hit was 136. Not enough. That's the better serve. He should take something off it, get a higher percentage in, because he's got some good variety. Well-disguised serve. He doesn't need to try to power it through Andre. He needs to get him stretching, reaching. Serve was only 102, but well placed. So is that.
Another, yeah. Point now for a two-love lead.
He tosses that ball up, and Agassi knows he may go up the middle and makes that serve tough to return. That's three excellent serves to get himself out of trouble.
17th ace secures the two-love lead. Well, it's a big night Tuesday. I know you're all anticipating, as we are, the premiere of the CBS Evening News with Katie Couric. A new era in news Tuesday night here on CBS. Well, Agassi with a couple of break chances that last game, but Becker had the goods and continues on his way with that big return winner.
There's just no safe place for Andre in this match. Not on his serve. He's not returning well enough. He's not fit enough to grind with Becker.
Becker sees Mary's lost a lot of sting on that serve, so he's just stepping in, and he's, you know, that's effective aggression. He's going over the low part of that. Those are pretty high percentage returns.
Lots of action today. Most of his third round. For a swing through.
Oh, how good is this? These first 3 points.
Three big return clean winners. And at love, Agassi broken again. Three love lead, double breakup. Is Benny Becker. We'll continue after this word from your local station.
The real battle begins. Broncos, Rams, Bengals, Chiefs. Kickoff 2006, next Sunday on CBS.
Track your fantasy team with lightning fast scores, in-depth stats, expert analysis, and much more. It's CBS Sportsline Fantasy Football, because the game matters.
From the producers of Friends and Mad About You, The Class, premieres CBS Monday, September 18th.
finally got rid of our old innerspring mattress. It's obsolete. We got a Sleep Number bed, the one you can adjust to as soft or as firm as you like. And then I noticed how many other things around here are obsolete. This clock, it's got hands. The TV has an antenna. This phone has a cord. From now on, if it's obsolete, it's out.
So should I start packing?
No, not today.
The Sleep Number bed by Select Comfort. Call 1-800-SLEEP-NUMBER.
Have you looked at your car's finish lately? Maaco is having a sale. Get half off our popular presidential paint package. If it's time to paint your car, visit your local Maaco Cosmolition specialist today.
The gift of love. Only the jewelry factory gives you quality at the right price. Circle Love pendants are $89. Diamond bands with 11 full-cut diamonds are $119. And 1/3 carat studs are $99. Buy factory direct and save. The jewelry factory in Livonia.
This is CBS Detroit. Everybody's watching.
So Benjamin Becker with a commanding two-break lead here to third set, 3-love. A set all at Arthur Ashe Stadium. Exactly 2 hours this match has been extended.
Law 13.
So, John, when you're down double break and you're hurting, not 100%, I mean, the chances are so slim of anything happening now in this set. You just can't fast forward and go to the fourth, but in philosophy, isn't that about where Agassi is?
Ironically, in his first two matches, you know, you mentioned that, and you'd think, you know, he's got to try to hold back and save something for the fourth or fifth, but, you know, he was up or down 4-love against Pavel and came back, won that set, and then he was up 4-love at 2-1 against Baghdatis and lost that set. So, you know, given those set of circumstances, I wouldn't say he's in that position yet here, especially after what happened. He almost had the chance, he had two break points to break back here the last time Becker served. But certainly looking grim at the moment for this third set.
Becker, by the way, on Thursday night wanted to watch the match between Andre Agassi and Marcos Baghdatis, and they wouldn't let him in. Didn't have a ticket. He tried to watch from one of the portals.
That was going for broke, but it worked.
He said he tried twice to get into Arthur Ashe Stadium and finally gave up, went home and watched the matches. So many did on hotel television.
See, this is what Andre, unfortunately, it's a desperate tactic, but it's about all he seems to have left. When he's lost matches of late, Agassi, he tries to go for too much, tries to hit as big as the guys he's facing. I gotta think that's his only shot at this stage, because he can't grind.
Nice pickup by Becker off the baseline. A point for 4-love.
There's a lot of players that have watched Agassi over the years hit that shot off the baseline and worked on it, and been able to improve upon it because of this very man. And that's a tough shot to hit, what Becker just did. Agassi looks like he's barely making the effort to hit the return. Then you look up and the ball's gone by you.
Well, so many guys can hit hard from the back, just bash. The guy who can do it without making a lot of mistakes is a man who stands out, and that's what Agassi's been able to do over the last decade, just cut down on his errors and give his opponents lots of chances to lose.
Ace sliced wide, number 18.
Those are the serves he should keep hitting. He doesn't need to go for the big bombs, especially as far back as Andre has to return.
And Andre went from being flamboyant when we first saw him here 21 years ago to being anti-flamboyant. And that's when he really started to get good, solid and steady, instead of just bashing. But I think his only chance to win this match is to go back to his flamboyant days. Just hit, you know, hit as cleanly and as few shots as possible.
It's painful for him to bend. I mean, he waits to the last instant to even get in a ready position. Yet he's, you know, he can still hit winners.
It's amazing. It's a tremendous talent, that hand-eye coordination. even with a stiff back, able to see it quickly and get a racket on it, that racket speed.
He's got to go for broke, and he's got to go for break at this stage.
Here's a break point. Get one of those rigs back. And does. 3-1. Okay, Mary, ever wonder what happened to the people with whom you went to school?
No.
Okay. Well, this group of friends is about to find out.
Tough luck.
The Class. Thanks for the help. A new comedy premieres Monday, September 18th on CBS. How about you, Jen?
Very frequently. Yeah.
Ask the wrong person.
No, I didn't have a high attendance record, frankly, in school. I didn't get to know them too much when I was even there.
That's hard to believe.
Yeah.
Someone as cerebral as you didn't go to class. Over the top of the net court.
Crowd's booing Becker.
But he's doing everything right. he's playing this match right. He's playing that particular shot just right.
How dare you hit a left corner? Go over.
How dare you move Agassi? How dare you put him in even more pain?
That's really what they're booing. Right?
That looked out.
Call was.
Yeah.
It is interesting. Conditions so dire for Agassi, and yet after he was broken in the first game of the set, he had a chance to break back and goes down a double break. And
he's still in the set.
Yeah. 100 mile an hour ace is 10. Ooh. Can't even straighten back up to the second serve.
Just after the first serve.
Look at he just didn't even straighten up. But he holds. It's 3-2.
Becker leads 3-2. First set, 1-2.
Mom? What? What's this?
A new Glade light show.
I mean, what's it doing in here?
Working.
Well, why in his room?
I can think of a few good reasons.
Introducing new Glade light show. It's an air freshener. It's a light show. It's new from Glade.
He gets rewarded for this?
Honey, think of it as a reward for all of us.
New Glade light show. See it, smell it, love it. S.C. Johnson, a family company.
Agent 24/7, come. Our exclusive relationship with Yahoo Real Estate has produced this. New internet technology that makes it easier than ever to find or sell a home.
Future of real estate.
Prudential Real Estate. The future of real estate now.
I'm gonna need all this.
Not that much, slugger. This'll do it.
Less is more with Charmin Ultra. That's because it's more absorbent. So you can use less than this regular quilted brand.
Good save!
Charmin Ultra. Best for bare bottoms.
Cha-cha-cha. Ultra!
Charmin! Come in and save at Circuit City's Red, White, and Blue Sale. You'll find hot deals in every department. And this Tuesday, pick up B-Day from Beyonce for just $9.99. At Circuit City.
It's just 1:35 in the afternoon on a beautiful blue sky Sunday. And out on the food courts in the plaza area and see the large screen television. Fans having a lunch, and Benjamin Becker serves it. One set all, and with a 3-2 lead. Led 3-love double break, and Agassi taking the last two games to maintain interest in this third set.
Well, he's made it a lot more interesting. It could be the challenge. Andre's going to challenge that.
They're involved. how quickly the official reviews. One of the possible arguments against this, it would delay play. It certainly has it. And Agassi, keen-eyed that he is.
No, he's wrong.
It was in. Okay.
15 ball.
Maybe saw that one with his heart. Under the circumstances, Becker flirting with trouble here, isn't he?
He's gotten edgy out there. He doesn't seem as comfortable. His motion's gone off a little bit on his serve. This is a chance for Agassi here to get right back in this set.
You saw Agassi loses one of his two challenges now in the set, and that did come into play. In his last match, didn't Baghdatis use both of his challenges?
He lost both, and he couldn't use any late in the fifth set.
And he could have actually had an overrule had he had a challenge left.
Still hasn't quite figured out Agassi how to return Becker. He's moved back. He's moved into the court. He's tried to cheat a certain way. He just can't get a good handle on the German serving.
That's good again. Boy, his depth of shot making has been quite remarkable as well. He's hit a lot of lines. Say you can visit usopen.org and watch the action live on your computer exclusively on usopen.org. 4-2.
Please. Open up.
86 mile an hour second serve works.
He senses a lot of people out here that are unsure of quite what's going on. You know, they're sort of edgy. You know, how bad is Andre feel? And, you know, you get the feeling Becker's starting to feel that as well. He's not quite sure what to do right now. That caught the line.
He's going to wear the paint off the baseline, Benjamin Becker.
Agassi is playing pretty quickly out there. Not wasting much time. Surprisingly fast.
And the 13th ace for Agassi. But he trails 4-3 in the third set.
The lifespan of a U.S. Open ball is 9 short games. So where do they go from there? Some resign themselves to menial tasks. Others try charity work. For a very, very lucky few, life is more exciting than ever. Lexus, proud sponsor of the U.S. Open.
Our network is out of control.
It's all these servers. I need more people.
I think we should buy more servers.
But that's the problem. Too many servers.
The servers are our friends. They want to serve us.
He's lost it.
What do we do?
We're switching over to IBM servers. Easier to manage. We can control everything from here now.
Stop! You're making them angry! No!
Take back control with the IBM System X featuring dual-core Intel Xeon processor.
You see a complex shipping industry. At Franklin Templeton, we saw a chance to invest in a logistics company whose technology streamlined shipping operations. A smart move for our fund shareholders. Perspective like this has made Franklin a leading equity manager. Franklin Templeton Investments. Gain from our perspective. Ask your advisor for a prospectus with investment goals, risks, fees, expenses, and other information to read and consider carefully before investing.
Sculptor Eric Fischels. Artistry out in the Arthur Ashe Commemorative Garden.
He's a big tennis fan, so he's very proud that it's out there. Beautiful. Becker 4-3, still up a break, but it's tight out there.
Agassi doing well to extend the point. Time running out on Agassi here in the third set. Oh. Taking that second serve and sending it back in a hurry.
If Becker doesn't look the same as he did when he came out physically, I mean, he didn't make much of an effort for that. You wonder if the emotions are getting to him, because he hasn't been in the situation before. This is only his second ever Grand Slam event. He looks like he's slowing down a bit. Maybe it's all mental. I tell you, I'm not so sure. He's struggling out there.
It's 30 all. Becker will enjoy a double break lead at 3-love.
It's worth noting that not only must this be an overwhelming experience for the 25-year-old German, but it's also his sixth match, because he had to go through three rounds of qualifying.
And remember, against Baghdatis, Agassi, although suffering from the back pain, it was Baghdatis who, in the final set, was falling apart with cramps.
Becker's three qualifying wins were best of three sets, not best of five. And you're lucky that this ball even went back over the court. You know, he recognizes this chance here.
And Becker with the ace takes a 5-3 lead. Well, out in that Arthur Ashe commemorative garden, there's a quote from Arthur. It says, "From what we get, we can make a living. What we give, however, makes a life." And some ways, when you think ahead to the man serving, who has given so much to the game and given so much in 60 million plus to charity, he has lived by those powerful words and message.
15. Becker's also just going for broke, not playing a lot of long points.
Fans looking at that shot as evil.
Now they want him. They don't want him to. They're booing him because he hit a drop shot. You got to hit it to him at least, they're saying. At least give him a chance.
Six times he's come away with a winner on that drop shot. It's all part of the competition.
He's not moving as well, though. Something's going on with him. 13-15.
No, he isn't moving as well. Raising questions as to his fitness. Couple of points for 5-4. Put the pressure on Becker to serve it out. Take a 2-1 lead. And that square will be when we return to Arthur Ashe Stadium. It'll be Becker at 5-4.
I love this one. It's quite romantic. Card member calls up, wants to take her husband to a really authentic Italian restaurant. I say, it's easy with our rewards program. Go online, pick almost any flight, you can pay with points, and go.
And, oh, tiramisu.
Italian food in Italy. Bellissimo.
This man finally popped the question.
You like it?
Oh, it's so beautiful.
But his Visa card was over the limit.
I'm so sorry. There seems to be a problem.
His fiancée told him to call American Express.
Call 1-800-THE-CARD for the Preferred Rewards Gold Card. Okay, this one's so cool. A gold card member wanted a special gift for his wife's birthday.
Oh.
So I got him tickets through gold card events for the concert of the year before they went on sale.
Got him.
With the American Express Preferred Rewards Gold Card, you get all this and more. Call 1-800-THE-CARD and apply now and experience a world of service.
Denise Basic is a real GEICO customer, not a paid celebrity. So to help tell her story, we hired a celebrity.
It was Thanksgiving night when I accidentally hit a deer.
Whoa! Look out! Look out!
I called GEICO expecting to get a recording, but someone was there to help me.
Help me! Somebody help me!
GEICO got my claim in the works right away, and I was actually able to enjoy my Thanksgiving.
Mashed potatoes, gravy, and cranberry sauce! Woo!
GEICO. Real service, real savings.
Andre Agassi giving fans here at Arthur Ashe Stadium, and it's a huge audience on this Sunday, 24,000 approaching that number. Some hope as he's put the pressure on Becker to serve it out on his serve at 5-4 for the 2-set-to-1 lead.
Get that. Oh my!
They can't salute him loud enough.
Talk about digging deep.
It's long. Love 30 opening. 4-year-old son, Jaden Gill, with Mama Steffi. And here in New York, for all family, 24,000 in support of Agassi. This is the kind of pressure that both Pavel and Bagdetis faced with a crowd so in support of Agassi. Another line.
Andre looks up to him and says, you're right, that was good. Still up 15-30.
Shot tracker, U.S. Open shot tracker actually inside the line. Agassi with 2 points from 5-all, however, trying to dig out of a double break deficit here in this third set.
This is in Baylor, Texas Tech right now for Becker. Andre looking ginger, pretty walking gingerly there.
He had to stretch wide for that forehand and nothing there to get back into the court, but it was long anyway.
Does hurt more when you miss.
And Becker continues to mount in that ace column, 20 now for him.
That's the biggest serve he's hit for a while. This came at a nice time for him, set point.
call confirmed by umpire Molina. There's the U.S. Open shot tracker and half a ball long. Straining to stay alive, but here's Becker with another set point. Kind of typical sight at the Grand Slams, big screens, television, those who can't get into the main show court. Benjamin Becker secures the set. 6-4, leads 2-1.
My cholesterol is out of whack. The doctor said my bad cholesterol's high, a real problem with my medical history. And get this, my good cholesterol's low, so he put me on Crestor. Crestor, along with diet, can lower the bad cholesterol. It can also raise the good. Crestor helps get my cholesterol where my doctor wants. That's more like it. Is Crestor right for you? Ask your doctor. Mine said Crestor isn't for everyone, like people with liver disease or women who are nursing, pregnant, or may become pregnant, and simple blood tests will check for liver problems. He also said to tell him about other medicines I'm taking, or if I have muscle pain or weakness, that could be a sign of serious side effects. Down with the bad, up with the good. How's your cholesterol? Crestor helps get your cholesterol right.
If you can't afford your medication, AstraZeneca may be able to help.
Come in and save at Circuit City's Red, White, and Blue Sale. You'll find hot deals in every department. And this Tuesday, pick up B-Day from Beyonce for just $9.99 at Circuit City.
Does knee pain limit your motion? Get relief with Icy Hot Pro Therapy. Powered by Cold Pack. Now I can scramble.
I can feel it work.
It goes the distance. Freedom. Pro Therapy from Icy Hot. It's about freedom of motion.
This is Julie. She can tell you how many medals Kenya won in the last 3 Summer Olympics.
22.
How many fouls it takes to foul out of a basketball game.
6 professional, 5 college.
The international dialing code for Denmark.
45.
But ask her about her credit score and she's clueless.
Steeplechase.
Knowing your credit score could save you thousands on your next home loan, car loan, or credit card. Log on to freecreditreport.com and find out how you can get your free credit score and report with enrollment in Triple Advantage. Don't be like Julie.
2-1.
Get the score.
In overtime.
Tomorrow.
Do you mind if I have a look?
Dave's up close and personal with Scarlett Johansson. Plus,
if I don't come back, you can have the show.
The American Chopper guys give Dave the ride of his life tomorrow.
And we welcome you back to our 7 hours of live coverage, over 20 hours through this Labor Day weekend, and Benjamin Becker during that break decided to go back into the locker room, a bathroom break. Mary, there was some word that Becker has had some problems with cramping as we look at the match summary through 3 sets.
Earlier this summer, he was playing the tough young kid Tursunov and cramped during that match. We've been mentioning that he looks a little stiff-legged in the last set of this one against Andre Agassi.
Well, he had to retire 2-1 in that match, and he's struggling out there right now. He didn't show any signs of emotion when he won this set. You would have thought when you go up 2-1 against Agassi, you'd be happy, but... he's not moving well. And it does look like he's either about to or start cramping.
Wouldn't that be something?
And all of a sudden, Agassi, you know, stepped it up. You know, hit that 120. Agassi's done this to so many opponents, you know, broken them down.
And another race. And so Agassi starts with an easy hold. That's As we check other action, what is it about Nalbandian? Why don't they just give his opponent two sets and then he start to play, see if he can win three in a row?
That's a second round match they're playing.
Because of the rain delays, so they really have a lot of catching up to do, whoever wins. Oh, number five seed, Nadia Petrova. Standing gold around. Robredo a two-set advantage.
He's done. He's looked good, Robredo.
Well, sweeting a good effort, but Olivier Rochus takes him out in five sets.
15.
Saw Davenport earlier in a tiebreak for that decisive set to move on to the fourth round. Schneider winner. But focus in this championship and on this day on the returner, Andre Agassi. His farewell to a great career. Fans hoping it'll be extended on to the fourth round. He has to battle out of a two-set-to-one deficit. But, his opponent certainly isn't dominating the action the way he did earlier in the match.
Now, the good news is it's starting to look like things are turning here in Agassi's favor. The bad news is he's going to have to come back tomorrow if he were to pull these last two sets out. That's going to be the transition. It's going to be awfully rough because it's clear that he's not moving as well as he did the first few rounds.
Andy Roddick and Fernando Verdasco are scheduled next here on Arthur Ashe Stadium, and the winner of that match will play the winner of this one tomorrow. Like that for you here on CBS.
The Agassi camp has already requested that if that were to happen, Andre would play at night, not during the day on Labor Day.
Is that all right with CBS?
Oh, yeah. They say, oh, sure, whenever you want. Absolutely.
Peruse the fact that that was a pretty easy chance to return. But not that one, swung wide, and a point now for one all in the fourth.
The cramping kid versus the guy with the old guy with the gimpy back, I mean.
And the hold for Becker, one all. Well, I know many of you out there enjoy the tremendous talent of Scarlett Johansson. Well, she's on with Dave tomorrow night on The Late Show. Dave goes, wait a minute, he's going to go on a wild chopper ride as well. What a show tomorrow. David Letterman here on CBS. Doesn't take Labor Day off.
He's a hard worker.
Becker not making much of an effort at all in the returning games. Agassi now with 16 aces. Got to be as high in a tournament match for a long time. Played over 2.5 hours just early in the fourth set. Your children.
It looks like he's having trouble walking right now, Becker.
And a give up ace to conclude that game.
Passion for tennis, a passion for life. Mass Mutual, the life insurance company proud to support both.
Some women travel great lengths to recover. I'd rather reactivate.
Olay Regenerist reactivates with twice the power. It makes tired skin look beautifully regenerated.
So why recover when you can reactivate?
Olay Regenerist. Love the skin you're in.
Dust may be a constant, but dusting doesn't have to be.
Rescue me!
How's that possible? In a word, Pledge.
Rescue me!
Our anti-dust formula doesn't just remove dust. It cleans your wood and keeps it looking less dusty, longer than dry dusting. It's so easy, you can do it with your eyes closed.
Rescue me!
The beauty of Pledge is that you dust less. Jesse Johnson, Family Company.
Well, a puzzling turn of events here in the fourth set with Agassi down 2-1. And his young opponent, Benny Becker, the former Baylor star, national collegiate champion, is suddenly almost immobile. And Agassi, playing with a bad back, has had his problems, but it's Becker here in the fourth set that's hardly taken a step on the returning games.
We have a new show here called Survivor Flushing Meadow, starring Andre Agassi and this man, 25-year-old Benjamin Becker.
His home is just 10 minutes from the Luxembourg border in Germany, not related to Boris Becker. Four years at Baylor, led the Bears to the national title, and he won the singles championship.
Well, the last thing to go is the serve. He's not able to use his legs quite as effectively, and you see he beat Grosjean. That was a good win for him. Varangi, close four setter. And look at right now, he's in some trouble, even though he's up 2-1. Big trouble. He's banking on holding and maybe, you know, somehow pulling this out in a breaker or something, because he's not making much of an effort on Andre's serve. He may not get there the way things are going.
And another line clipped by Becker.
No, not yet called the trainer. I see a pair of Bastolt in the corner waiting. I think a call would be imminent or soon.
Full field.
Ace out wide on the slice.
But both guys know their opponents aren't moving as well, so they can try to just hang on here. It's clearly what they're both doing for different reasons.
Becker, the advantage of a 2-1 lead, and a point here for 2-2 in the fourth. And he's got it. Next up will be Andy Roddick, champion here 3 years ago, defeating Juan Carlos Ferrero in the finals. And Roddick's had a terrific summer with Jimmy Connors, his new coach. He's lost only one match of 15 on the hard courts, and he meets Fernando Verdasco next.
Eight winners for Becker in this match. 13-0.
And Agassi with 18 aces.
Twice the amount of Agassi.
What a stab return by Agassi, and rewarded with a point.
Becker hit that return is about as hard as he can hit one. He had a ball that he should have made, but I think he was in shock the ball came back.
Another wild forehand.
It's all or nothing for Becker.
Big again. Of course, through his collegiate years and most of his experience in his tennis life has been just two or three. So to be extended beyond three sets is a new experience for Becker.
So, long weekend coming up. You doing anything?
Yeah. Heading over to Home Depot. We're going to paint the living room. You?
Me too. And we're going to buy a new refrigerator.
We're going to paint, buy a new fridge, and rebuild our deck.
And...
oh, please.
Start your long weekend at the Home Depot. Right now, get no payments, no interest for 12 months store-wide when you use your Home Depot consumer credit card. Plus, get 10% off appliances.
The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
This marvelous chance to win.
I feel pretty, oh so pretty.
I feel pretty and witty
and bright.
And I pity
any girl who isn't me tonight.
I feel charming,
oh so charming.
It's alarming how charming I feel.
I'm so pretty
that I hardly can believe I'm real.
See that pretty girl in the mirror there?
Such a pretty face.
Such a pretty dress. Such a pretty smile.
Such a pretty face.
I feel pretty.
Oh, so pretty.
I feel pretty and witty
and bright.
And I pity it.
Every Sunday, a lot can happen in 60 minutes.
Come on, 60 minutes.
See? 60 minutes, all new this fall.
Qualifier Benjamin Becker with a 2-1 lead. No breaks here in the fourth. Becker, not the energy that he came out on the court with to start this match. That was 2 hours and 41 minutes ago. Serving a 2-3. Becker's coach at Baylor is reportedly here to support him today, Matt Canole. Apparently, and Benny told us in our visit that, you know, it was good for him to go to college 4 years. He needed to mature. In fact, he was terribly homesick his freshman year at Baylor. Slaps another line with that ace. And that, in fact, so much so that as a freshman, felt so lonely and homesick that didn't feel motivated, and Coach Canole wouldn't let him hit with a varsity until he straightened up his emotional act. We found him a very thoughtful, mature 25-year-old, and he said that it was the best thing I could have done. That if I had tried to play professional tennis the normal age, I never would have had a chance.
He's not a big guy. He's only listed at 5'10". He's a lot of power on his shots, and that's taking its toll on him. In the moment, obviously, Peltier, a lot of cramp in his mouth. And, he is just at the edge right here.
Agassi looking for that break to try to send this one to five. Good pace on that forehand from Becker's end.
The pace isn't his problem, that's for sure. He can hit a big ball.
Many more winners and almost double the unforced errors from Becker's end. 69 winners in the match to 34 for Agassi. And another. He hit 70 in the win column. Well, coming Thursday to CBS, apparently this has hit written all over it. Academy Award nominee James Woods redefines the courtroom drama in the most anticipated new show of the season, Shark premieres Thursday, September 21st, after CSI. Three all in the fourth, and Agassi earns the first point.
See Agassi going back on the return, just trying to get in a rally. You see Becker moving forward, just going for outright winners.
Joe Fernandez did talk with the ATP trainers and said there's apparently nothing physically wrong with him. He certainly
hasn't spoken to him. He hasn't brought him out yet on the court. You know, taking a look at him.
Does that surprise you? Is that just his youth and inexperience on the pro level? Nothing.
Part of it is absolutely mental. There's no doubt about it. You know, but this is, you know, he's been out there almost 3 hours, and we've pointed out he's not used to playing five-set matches.
Van Agassi
looking to play short points, that's for sure.
Agassi having his own way on his serve.
I think it happens to a lot of guys over 50. See, I was always going during the movies and hating to stand up, going during a presentation and hating to stand out. And once I got there, I had trouble going, and I was going 3 times a night. I said to my doctor, I have a going problem. He said, you have a growing problem. It's not your bladder, your prostate is growing. See, I had an enlarging prostate. My doctor prescribed Avodart.
Most medicines only treat symptoms. Avodart, with time, actually shrinks the prostate and improves urinary symptoms.
So, I can go more easily when I need to go. And go less often.
Only your doctor can tell if your symptoms are from an enlarged prostate and not a more serious condition such as prostate cancer, so have regular prostate exams. Avodart is for men only. Women should not take or handle Avodart due to the risk of a specific birth defect. Tell your doctor if you have liver disease. Rarely, sexual side effects, tenderness, or swelling of the breast can occur. Call your doctor today. Avodart, for your growing problem.
You're too heavy.
Switch.
First name or last?
Last.
Seven a.m. Court one, Phillips.
A passion for tennis, a passion for life. Mass Mutual, the life insurance company proud to support both.
He came home for just one day, but this was no ordinary day. JoJo premieres Wednesday, September 20th.
Becker serving 3-4, fourth set. Agassi came bouncing out, a little more happiness in his step as he returned to court. Whether he's feeling better, or this is just to show his opponent that he's ready to break him.
I think he's feeling better, because Becker's feeling worse. Give him some hope here to pull this out in five. He's not been in any long, tough rallies this set, and that's good for Andre, too.
You know, with Becker going for his shots, he hit or miss, it's saved Agassi from running around the court to retrieve. Becker still has that weapon. A very good serving match for him. Percentage is under 50% for the match, but his aces and service winners are quite outstanding. There's Coach Matt Canole. Baylor took his team to the 2004 National Championship with Becker being his star and the collegiate singles champion that year.
Were there any Americans on that team? Do you know?
It was dominated, as most tennis teams are, by outstanding foreign players.
He held that too long. He could have hit the drop shot there. Just floated on Becker. Too much time to think about that.
And the way he moved with that ball, Agassi had to put that in his memory bank. Wouldn't surprise me to see him try a little dropper on Becker. As Agassi, 30 all here at 3-4.
forward.
132 miles an hour, and he still got that big first serve. 23 aces for Becker. Sure, this isn't the man related to Boris?
Boris Light. They both hold.
And he holds for all the score here in the fourth.
Four games old. Hold set.
Speaking of the marathon man, how about David Nalbandian? I mean, he's just automatic. He loves those five setters. He's rallied from two sets down against Murat Safin.
That's amazing. One-sided there.
Yeah, it's young Djokovic is a terrific talent. Good battle there, Novak and Melisse. Let's go, Andre. New York cheer. Lost only two of his last 18 service points.
Got new balls, and he threw that down at 119. He's got some zip on that serve again.
Russian Mikhail Yuzny sends home the number 11 seed David Ferrer of Spain. Olivier Rokas spoils the dreams of young Sweeting. John, we've seen some errant shots, but in this set, some of the efforts by Becker are 30 feet off the court.
Now, Agassi's also serving in the 80s, and he's not even going after them, it seems, Becker. 21st ace for Andre.
He's just hoping to take this into a tiebreak, Becker, and somehow pull it out.
And Becker's service percentages have gone down steadily, and Agassi's have gone up.
Agassi has won 20 of the last 22 service points.
What's big about Ziploc? Is your idea of storage a bit too square? With Ziploc big bags, tight spaces are perfect places. For storage, don't box it. Ziploc big bag it. Ziploc, designed with you in mind. What's big about Ziploc? Big bags. Sleepover stuff? Pick it up. Blankets, quilts? Stack it up. Sports stuff? Toss it all in a Ziploc big bag designed with you in mind.
Paula Sela is a real Geico customer, not an actor. So to help tell her story, we hired that announcer guy from the movies.
When the storm hit, both our cars were totally underwater.
In a world where both of our cars were totally underwater,
we thought it would take forever to get some help.
But a new wind was about to blow.
With Geico, we had our check in 2 days.
Payback. This time, it's for real.
Geico. Real service, real savings.
Come in and save at Circuit City's Red, White, and Blue Sale. You'll find hot deals in every department. And this Tuesday, pick up B-Day from Beyonce for just $9.99. At Circuit City.
My allergies can get so bad, I feel like I'm in a fog. Now, I'm Claritin Clear. Claritin relieves my sneezing and itchy eyes without making me drowsy. And it's proven to make me alert and focused. That one, please. Live Claritin Clear.
Well, Agassi's performance has enlivened the hopes of this large crowd at Arthur Ashe Stadium that's rooting so vociferously in his behalf. Now it's Becker's serving at 4-5 to stay in the fourth set. But the facts of the matter here in the fourth set, neither servers had any problems. The returner's never gone beyond a 30 score in any game. There's a turnabout. Becker with a rash of errors. Agassi a clean set. Hasn't had to hit many balls. Just when hope rises, he comes up with that goods on the serve. 130 miles an hour down the middle.
It's like a puncher in boxing. The last thing to go is the punch. You still got the serve. You have to move for that.
15-30 opening for Agassi. 2 points from squaring this match at 2 sets all.
You can see more and more errors because he just doesn't believe in his fitness. The occasion is overwhelming here.
Then he goes out wide, just misses.
Andre's going to, it looked like it caught the outside of the line, but he's going to give it, this will be the second challenge. Or is that the last? I'm losing track now. 2 a set.
He's got both challenges left. And it was indeed good. And he's been perfect. 4 for 4 in the match. 4 challenges, and he's been right 4 times.
Agassi challenged that one. He was looking for him. Get that break points. He's 2 points from leveling this match here.
So Agassi's tried to help this crowd along, but now he has 1 challenge left in this set. Now they've got 1 red light up there, but I guess they've not corrected that, so he's used both his challenges. They both pick up a challenge in the tiebreak if it should go to that.
Here's set point.
Oh, they're aching to send it up another few decibels. They're on their feet. To be a gust of wind right in the middle of that point,
which made things even trickier. Total miss it, and Becker went in.
Fans thought that the serve was long. The shot tracker indicates it just did hit the line. Boy, he has really painted the line throughout this match, and that one, no dispute, another ace.
And he can't challenge now, so he's got to accept that call.
25th ace. And another, Benny Becker.
Hey, this guy's hanging tough, though. You got to hand it to him. I mean, he hasn't called out the trainer. He's clearly struggling. He's still put himself in a winning position.
And in this environment, so anti against him. Has a 2-set-to-1 lead now. Goes back to Agassi. Becker just doing absolutely zero with the Agassi serves. 21 of the last 23 service points taken by Agassi.
He's not even finding the court with a lot of these returns. He's just slapping at him. Yeah, at least he bunted it in.
The best he's looked in this set off the Agassi serve, that's for sure. That was finally around.
Coming into this game, Agassi had only lost 2 points on his serve on this set. And now he's lost a couple in this game.
All of a sudden he's come to life here.
First time Becker's seen a 15-30 on the board this entire set on his behalf. Goodness.
That's an incredible shot.
How big an effort by Becker in this game. Now he's got a couple of breakers and could serve for the match.
He's really fallen quiet in his return games until just now.
And another winner, 81st winner of the match for Benjamin Becker, a game away from the fourth round.
It's a comfortable feeling. knowing your annuity from Prudential can bring you a check every month for the life of your retirement. Prudential Financial. Growing and protecting your wealth for retirement.
For some, failure is inevitable. Others strive for something more, only to take their place among the masses, while a truly elite few will rise to greatness. Lexus, proud sponsor of the U.S. Open.
Olympus may be a familiar face, but Olympus is also a world leader in research and clinical microscopes and diagnostics. Created the first camera that let doctors look inside the human body. And we continue to introduce life-altering imaging technologies for healthcare professionals. We're proud of these accomplishments, but we're most proud of how we enrich lives around the world every day.
Generous applause from the fans as both men return to the court. You had a sense some were applauding Agassi's last walk as a world tennis star as Benjamin Becker serves for the match. Becker had done absolutely nothing on Agassi's service games this entire set, and then comes up with four consecutive winners to break Agassi to take the 6-5 lead in the fourth.
I'll tell you, he must know something we didn't, because he just he looked out of it and he just suddenly just turned it on, and he's 2 points away here. You never know in sports.
140 mile an hour miss. Still got the bigs. And it's long.
He just started to cramp there.
He's just going to make it. Yep, he did.
His three-match points, though, meanwhile.
They stand as one.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Play the ready. Thank you very much.
God, I don't think they're going to totally stop applauding.
No, they did.
And the ace for Benjamin Becker. Move over, Boris. A new Becker's in town. And he, a qualifier, is into the fourth round as he sends Andre Agassi into retirement on his 27th ace. Foeman Becker with all the rest applauding. And now his 4-year-old son and 2-year-old daughter will have daddy at home and a new puppy with it. And his life has been 36 years of tennis. He was with his dad striking a ball in the crib before he was 1 year old. So there's a lot of emotion to pour out.
USGA wanted to do something special for Andre Agassi at this, his final U.S. Open, and he said no. But you try to tell these fans not to give him thanks.
Talk about a lot of love. They're not going to stop.
All of it well deserved. You know, it's incredible that we're sitting here finally for the last time. But he's not going to play again. He just didn't think it was going to end.
As rich a salute as I've ever seen. The only way New Yorkers know how to do it so well.
New Yorkers are more famous for giving people the raspberry, but we're pretty good at this too, aren't we?
What an outpouring. Out in the plaza, and now the final bow. Mary Jo Fernandez is down on the court, and as soon as the crowd allows, we're going to hear from young Becker. Let's go down to Mary Jo.
Thanks, Dick. What a moment, Benjamin. Can you put into words what playing Andre in his final match was like?
No, I mean, it all seemed like a movie for me today, playing Andre. You know, he was my idol growing up. You know, I've followed his whole career. He's... He's definitely one of a kind. You know, he bring so much to tennis. You know, he's such a gentleman. You know, I got to know him a little bit. You know, it's for me, it was a great honor to play him. Obviously, it's a great moment for him, though. So everything should be for him. Knowing the crowd, you know, whatever they did for him, he deserves it. You know, whatever he did. So.
Well, congratulations. You deserve a lot of credit, too. Good luck in the next round. Let's hear it for Benjamin.
I want to wish him all the best. You know, I know he's going to be very happy in life, and I wish him all the best. And, you know, Andre, thanks.
Thanks, Benjamin. Wants to say a few words.
Thanks. The scoreboard said I lost today, but what the scoreboard doesn't say is what it is I have found. And over the last 21 years, I have found loyalty. You have pulled for me on the court and also in life. I have found inspiration. You have willed me to succeed, sometimes even in my lowest moments. and I have found generosity. You have given me your shoulders to stand on, to reach for my dreams, dreams I could have never reached without you. Over the last 21 years, I have found you, and I will take you and the memory of you with me for the rest of my life. Thank you.
Rachel Stern, and this is my story. I'm having a ball as a senior citizen. I'm in a show right now. I lead a discussion group. I volunteer at a hospital. If I'm not doing something like that, then I just go shopping. I have arthritis in both my ankles, arthritis in the shoulder, arthritis in my back. If you've got pain, you can't do all the things that I do at my age. I take a leave. I've been taking it about 3 years since I found out I had a spur in my heel. Forgot to tell you about that. I take whatever it does to keep me going, and that's what keeps me going, a leave, so I'm going to keep on taking it. They're going to have trouble putting the lid on me.
Mom? What? What's this?
A new Glade light show.
I mean, what's it doing in here?
Working.
Well, why in his room?
I can think of a few good reasons.
Introducing new Glade light show. It's an air freshener. It's a light show. It's new from Glade.
He gets rewarded for this?
Honey, think of it as a reward for all of us.
New Glade light show. See it, smell it, love it. S.C. Johnson, a family company.
Denise Basic is a real Geico customer, not a paid celebrity. So to help tell her story, we hired a celebrity.
It was Thanksgiving night when I accidentally hit a deer.
Whoa, look out, look out!
I called Geico expecting to get a recording, but someone was there to help me.
Help me! Somebody help me!
Geico got my claim in the works right away, and I was actually able to enjoy my Thanksgiving.
Mashed potatoes, gravy, and cranberry sauce!
Geico. Real service, real savings.
The CBS Evening News with Katie Couric begins Tuesday.
Diamonds. The Jewelry Factory has thousands for every budget. 1 carat solitaires, $5.99. 1 carat ISI diamonds, $2,900. And exotic deep flawless and large fancies at low prices. Buy factory direct and save. The Jewelry Factory in Livonia.
Strangers in the night. Exchanging glances.
No two people are the same, which becomes obvious as soon as they share a bed. That's why we created the Sleep Number bed. It allows each person to set their side of the bed to their sleep number, which is their level of ideal firmness. A Sleep Number is the key to a perfect night's sleep. The Sleep Number bed by Select Comfort. Call 1-800-SLEEP-NUMBER.
Have you looked at your car's finish lately? Maaco is having a sale. Get half off our popular presidential paint package. If it's time to paint your car, visit your local Maaco Cosmolition specialist today.
Millionaire, giving you a reason to shout. Tomorrow at 9 on CBS Detroit.
This U.S. Open update is sponsored by American Express.
It was one of the most amazing scenes you'll ever see in sports. Andre Agassi, you have given me shoulders to stand on to reach for my dreams. Andre, to the crowd here at the U.S. Open as he says goodbye after a remarkable career. Bill McAtee, Patrick McEnroe back in our U.S. Open studio, and it was really, I mean, it was a very powerful thing to watch.
It's amazing, Bill. You know, sports is, I guess it's winning and losing, you know, and for Andre, we're going to remember his win, certainly, but I think for him, what we took from his whole process, from his whole journey, is that it's about the human spirit. It's about figuring out something about yourself, bringing people along for the ride, letting people into your emotions, and boy, if everyone ever figured out how to enjoy the process and learn from it and mature from it, I think we all learned a lesson from Andre through this whole thing.
Because of the rain, we got a chance to see some of his greatest moments, some of his most disappointing moments here at the U.S. Open, and we've watched him from that kid who images everything, who was a little bit bratty, to the elder statesman, the mature adult, the man who gives so generously, and that was a very interesting evolution to watch.
Yeah, he figured it out. I mean, he figured out that it's not just about the flash, that it's not just about the wins and losses. It's about growing as a person, getting to a place where you haven't been, and you know, as the proud father that he is of two children, what an example to set, and I think what an example for everyone in the stadium today.
Well, an amazing day, a remarkable moment here in New York. Andy Roddick is coming up next. He will take on Fernando Verdasco when we return to the Open in New York after these messages.